Dear students, this is the fifth video of the chapter Socialism in Europe and Russian Revolution. And today we are going to discuss about the topic Socialism in Russia. So we have to understand that how socialism reached Russia and how the ideas of socialism implemented in Russia. So far we discussed that the Tsar Nicholas was ruling in Russia, and we also discussed about the economic and social condition of Russia. And we came to the conclusion that basically in Russia, the peasants were there and they were subdivided. Here I would like to add one more thing, that peasants, they were ready to distribute their land and they were trying to get all the benefits of the collective land. So basically collective farming was going on with the help of peasants. Now we'll have to understand that before 1914, all the political parties were banned, were considered illegal, because many political parties emerged. Like here it is written that in 1898 Social Workers Democratic Party emerged, similarly in 1900 Social Revolutionary Party emerged, but all these parties were considered illegal. They were banned by Tsar Nicholas. Why? Because he was an autocrat. He was a monarch. So why would he allow such party? So basically, the Social Workers Democratic Party came to support the peasants. Similarly, Social Revolutionary Party also came to support different types of peasants, because peasants were getting much problem in that region. And some groups were thinking that we are naturally socialist. Why? Because we are distributing our land and we are getting the profit on the basis of collective farming or joint farming. So basically this is the socialist nature. Now after that, one question raised in Russia, that who will hold the flag of revolution? Who will hold the flag of socialism? The peasant or worker? That was the question. Initially, most of the people considered that peasants, most people considered peasants would hold the flag of socialism in Russia. But after that it was found that the peasants were not ready. The peasants were not ready at the time to hold the flag of socialism. Why? Because they were still divided on the basis of many things. Some were rich, some were poor. So this is why the problem started. So you have to understand, the peasants were there, but they were not united. And that is why the problem started. Now, so finally, Lenin came forward. Vladimir Lenin, he was a leader. And he was the leader of Socialist Revolutionary Party. He came forward and he divided his party into two forms. And he took the Bolshevik group. So Bolshevik group and Menshevik group, two different groups were formed. And Lenin took the command of Bolshevik party. So this is how he took the command, and he demanded that the peasants should not be considered as a flag bearer or flag holder of the socialism, but in its place, workers should be given chance to move forward with the idea of socialism. So the workers were given chance, and the group Bolshevik that was led by Lenin, it got the chance to lead them. So here we'll have to understand that how the socialism gained popularity in Russia. So what we discussed so far, we discussed that how socialism became very popular in Russia. So we have to understand that socialism was an ideology, and it was about distribution of profit among the masses. It was against the concentration of property or resources in few hands. And the workers were in a position to lead the revolution against the present regime and to bring about ideas of socialism in Russia. So basically workers were given emphasis and workers were given chance to go with the idea of socialism or to establish the idea of socialism in Russia. Thank you.